Welcome again, Mwalimu Jeff Bama. Today, I will be able to illustrate the summary of chapter 1 in Blossoms of the Savannah by Henry Olet. Welcome, feel free, and enjoy the flow of the book. We realize that as the book begins, in chapter 1, Olekaino is set to move from Nakuru to Nasila. By doing this, he is moving because he is retrenched from AgriBits Limited, where he has been a manager. And now that he is going back to Nasila, he has no others except to relocate and organize himself in business so that he can continue being rich. Now, at the beginning, we realize that Olekaino reprimands Lodas for being slow. And now that he reprimands them, his daughter Taiyo recalls how earlier on his father Olekaino denies her a chance to attend a music extravaganza in Mombasa. And now that when the Lodas are facing the reprimand, Taiyo has got mercy on these Lodas because she knows the nature of her father. She understands her father very well. Remember, in that instance of reprimanding Lodas is what brings about the flashback of how Taiyo comes on the instance where she is denied a chance to attend a music extravaganza in Mombasa so that she could develop her talent. The two daughters of Olekaino, that is Raisian and Taiyo, visualize on how life is going to be like in Nasila. That is why Raisian asks Taiyo, how do you think life is going to be like in Nasila? And remember, Taiyo advises that they should hope for the best because she is the firstborn child of Olekaino. Now she has to advise Raisian because Raisian is younger. Taiyo encourages that they should hope for the best. Raisian requests Taiyo to plead with their father so that they can join Egerton University before they go back to Nasila, so that their father Olekaino can allow them to join Egerton University. Raisian knows her father listens to Taiyo. She knows that because of the love that their father has towards Taiyo, Raisian is aware that if she can use Taiyo to plead to their father, then their father can understand. Through a flashback, we are told that Olekaino and his wife, Mama Glanoe, get married 22 years earlier, and they have lived together for 22 years in marriage. We also get to understand that while the family of Olekaino lives in Nakuru, some women from Nasila had visited so that they could caution Mama Mlanoe of the status, the marital status of her daughters. that if the daughters are not married off because of the age, then there were to be consequences. So these women from Nasila had visited Ai before Olekaelo gets retrenched. That Mama Villanoe has to understand the consequences which are to be there if the daughters are not married early enough. Now, as the journey progresses to Nasila, in between Nakuru and Nasila, a few kilometers to Nasila, one of the lorries develops a mechanical problem. Thereafter, the problem is fixed and the journey continues to Nasila. The family of Olekaelo arrives in Simiren's homestead. They are welcomed by many elders of Nasila so that they can feel at home, and they are really appreciated for going back home. And every other leader in Nasila or elder, they are concerned about the monogamous status of Olekaelo. Because we do understand that Simiren, his younger brother, has been in charge of the family while Olekaelo has been in Nakuru. So, being the second one in the Kaelo family, Simiren takes the responsibility of leading and guiding the family from Olekaelo. And we are told that Simiren has four wives and 16 children. That is why, because Olekaelo is the first one, but maybe Olekaelo is the first one in the Kaelo family, elders in Nasila are concerned about the monogamous status, that this man should marry another wife who should bear him a son. Now that Mama Villanoe has born two daughters only, and there is no son to carry the name of Pasimei to the next generation, the leaders are highly concerned the moment the family of Olekaelo arrives in Nasila. They get to understand that things in Nasila are very different. The daughters of Olekaelo get to understand that in Nasila, life is different from that of Nakuru. Thank you. That is the end of chapter 1. I will explain the next chapter next time. Thank you. Be blessed.